Want to get your reaction to the big news of this week, which is that the CDC changed its mask guidance yesterday to recommend that people in substantial and high transmission areas, vaccinated people, wear masks indoors in public spaces. They also said health officials said that they had data showing that vaccinated individuals who get breakthrough infections have viral loads that are the same as unvaccinated individuals, although they are far less likely to get sick. So, what's your reaction to the guidance? How do you think the CDC handled this? And where do you think we are as a country at this point in the pandemic?
So I will tell you, Yasmin, first of all, personally, I never stopped wearing a mask. I literally, today is Wednesday. I think Saturday, I got my reuptake of my N95 masks. 50 of them came in the mail because I didn't stop. I've always worn, and I'm vaccinated, just to be clear. I've always worn a mask when I go indoors to the grocery store or indoors to a pharmacy or the post office. I also wear my mask when I go outdoors and there are crowds, farmers markets or very crowded streets and people are walking around. I put my mask on. I don't wear my mask, when I go bike riding or when I walk in the park or when I walk down the street and there just aren't any people, or you're just passing one or two people and you can put a wide swath between you and them. I think that's the right answer. I think the CDC's guidance, as David Leonhardt pointed out this morning, is it's a little confusing to the average layman. It says in high transmission areas and, requires you then to go and look at the map or go and look at what is a high transmission area? Do I live in that? If I go from where I am to a high transmission area, say over a county line. So I just think common sense says two things. You're going indoors, you're going into crowded, even outdoor areas, wear a mask. That's not asking you to wear a mask 8 hours a day, all day long in hot and humid weather. It is for defined periods of time. Wear a good mask. Upgrade your mask to a NIOSH approved N95 mask. There are plenty of them that are made in the United States. They're not expensive and use them well. I think, we're focused on masking. I think we also need to be focused on high quality masks that fit your face really well. And I noticed that there are various sites where you can also look and see high quality cloth masks if the N95 is for some reason not something you can wear because of allergies or other problems.